Hello, Virgo. This is Bonnie from Soul Start Bliss with your February 2020 mini tarot reading. Happy Valentine's Day and lots of love to you in all areas. Let's take a shuffle here and see what's coming up for you. Gosh, I can't believe we're in 2020. It seems like the time flies by. This new decade, who knows what it's going to bring for us. Let's take a look. Please remember this is a general reading, and if you'd like one just about you, I've included my link down below to my website, www.soulstarbliss.com. Get yourself an appointment, and we'll get to it as quickly as we can. Let's take a look here and see what's coming for you. Wow, it says you're finally ready to make those choices. It says, don't be worrying about feeling like a fool. You know, you don't have to be perfect every single time. Although you usually are. It just says, you're going to make some choices here this month about whatever, you know, whether it be love, money, job, you know, health. It just says, make them. You can't choose wrong. It says, if you have to make some choices this month, do them and do what's best for you. It's the only thing that will make no change is no choice. You're going to have opportunities in a lot of areas this month for change and for improvement. And it says, you know, don't worry how the past was. Maybe you chose wrong. Maybe things, you know, fell apart. Maybe things weren't perfect. But it says you can't change what's wrong. You can just learn from it and work with what you have. There is going to be gaining in the midst of change this month. Is everything going to be perfect? Is all this, you know, worries from the past going to go away? Maybe not. But it says that you're strong. And when you realize how strong you are and how you can change some things by moving forward rather than, oh, poor me. And there's nothing where everyone gets to be, oh, poor me and be the victim for a while. But when you say enough is enough is enough, and you're going to do something, I think that's for a lot of you this month. Those of you that are really feeling like, why is this happening? Figure out, you know, find something for gratitude. I don't care how small it is, and you'll see a change for yourself. It says when you do that, it's going to be a change for you. You're going to be like a you're going to change some of the negative thinking that's been going on to positive thinking. I'm not saying all of it has been, but those of you that have had a lot of negative things happen, try to turn them around, and you're going to see a change for yourself. For the better. It says, you know, you might feel like you're all alone and nobody seems to understand you. That, you know, that's okay too. Just work on yourself. Don't worry what others say or what others do, because it's none of their business what you do, actually. But it says, Ace of Cups, when your mind is filled with spirit, it fills your body to overflowing. What you think about, you become. And yes, when you're having dark night of the soul or pain from the past or things are falling apart, it's really kind of hard to find the rainbow there, but you got to look for it. Okay, no matter how small the gratitude, it can certainly change things. Or maybe how you look at things. If you look at it as, you know, this is the end of the line, this is doom and gloom, I have a feeling that's where you're going to stay. But if you can see, like, you know, tomorrow's a better day, or I'll make a different choice. Seriously, if you can just make a few little changes, I think you're going to be quite happy with yourself and the progress that will change things. Again, don't worry so much what other people say, because they're not walking in your shoes. They're not paying your bills. They're, you know, other people. It's easy to look from the outside to see what's going on, but until you walk the walk, you really don't know. But it just says here, when you change the way you look at things, things are definitely going to change. And I know that sounds like a riddle, but even the smallest little change will bring more change for you in a positive way. A lot of spirit help around you. You don't have to walk alone. Remember that, Virgo, you got big shoulders, but there's help all around for you. When you ask spirit to guide you or send your help, or you call on your angels, or you pray to God, creator, whoever you pray to, let them do the work. You know, we can't say, well, I need $539 by Tuesday, and I need it in a pink bag wrapped up in my mailbox. Just ask for what you need, and then let them bring it to you in the way that is supposed to come. I hope I made that clear. Wheel of Fortune says things are definitely going to get better for you. Things seem to be, or looks like, going to be on a course of falling into place, but it's going to be from effort that you've put in already or you start with. It's not hocus pocus, poof, everything's perfect, although I guess it could be, but it says one step at a time. If you need to clean up your finances, make a plan. If you need to make more money, start looking for a new job or find a promotion at work, whatever it might be in the love area. If you're in a relationship and it's kind of fizzled, Valentine's Day is pretty special. It's a good time to rekindle stuff. It says, don't be afraid. Be who you are. You're really a caring, interesting person. And it says, sometimes you're afraid to show your heart on your sleeve, but it might be just what's needed. It says, new beginnings here are available for you. You may be hearing from someone from the past in the love area. For those of you that are single, that's been prominent today too. Let them prove their self. You know, just because someone says they changed doesn't mean they have. Or someone that was great before could have certainly changed to the other way. So just take your time, and I don't think you'll be hurt disappointed. You might be, I don't know, but I'm just saying, if you take your time and you see what's going on, pay attention. Because there looks like there's going to be some reasons to celebrate this month for you. It says abundance is possible, but it also could be abundance. So many people, including myself, usually go to dollars, but it can be joy, bliss, and ease, and money, or it could be just money. But whatever it is, it's on the way. So welcome it and bring it to you. It says, put your worries to rest best you can. I'm not saying, you know, you owe $10,000 in bills. Oh, forget about that. If that's the case, make a plan. If you're, ill, go see a doctor. Just be a person of action, okay? Don't delay anymore some things that you can make a change with. And it might be, if you can't do it, you can contact somebody that can help you, because there's a lot of help around you. You don't have to walk this walk by yourself. It says messages are going to be important this month, Virgo, so pay attention. And I feel like those of you that are have been working in business or working on starting a business or getting a business going could be the month where things are lined up for you finally. So hallelujah, Virgo. This is Bonnie from Soul Star Bliss. Thank you so much for dropping in, and I'll see you again next month.